And welcome to this tutorial on enlarging the system prompt and using the magnifier on the Google Nexus 7. In this tutorial, I am using the Google Nexus 7 running Android 4.4, also known as KitKat. And I will be covering the following topics. First, I'll tell you how to increase the system prompt size. Then I will tell you how to change the wallpaper to improve the contrast between the text and the icons on the home screen. And finally, I will show you how to use the inbuilt magnifier in Android. So the first thing I'm going to do is change the font size. So first I go into the Applications menu, and I want Settings. So I tap on Settings, and now I choose Display. Now I'll choose font size, and for this example I'm going to choose huge, and already you can see the size of the text has increased. The next thing I'm going to do is change the wallpaper. So I tap on wallpaper, and there are several different types of wallpaper you can have in Android. Live wallpaper tends to have an animated background, which I don't really recommend for the home screen. For this example, I'm just going to use plain wallpaper. So I tap on wallpaper, and now I'm going to choose the wallpaper I want. So I'm going to choose this quite dark, plain wallpaper. So I tap on set wallpaper, and now I can press on the home button. And as you can see now, the contrast between the text and the background is a lot clearer. So now, I will show you how to use the magnifier. First, I'll go into the application menu, and choose Settings. Then, I need to scroll down to Accessibility, and tap on Accessibility. And now, I want to switch on Magnification Gestures. So I tap on Magnification Gestures, and then I tap on the switch at the top right hand corner of the screen. So as you can see, nothing appears to have happened. To switch on the magnifier, I have to triple tap on the screen with one finger. So I go 1, 2, 3, and that switches on the magnifier. Now I can move around the screen by using two fingers and dragging them around the screen. So I can move up, down, left, and right. If I want to increase or decrease the size of the text on the screen, I can use the pinch and zoom gesture. So to increase the magnification, I simply place two fingers on the screen next to each other and pull them apart. And now to decrease the magnification, I place my two fingers away from each other on the screen and bring them together. And to switch the magnifier off, I just triple tap with one finger. Now it's also possible that you might just want to temporarily switch on the magnifier. And you can do this by triple tapping and then holding the finger. So if I do 1, 2, 3 hold, the screen will now be magnified. Now, keeping my finger on the screen, I can move around to different areas of the screen. As soon as I lift my finger, the magnification goes back to normal. So this is quite useful if you just quickly want to see what a button is or what an option is. Now, one of the limitations of the magnifier in Android is that it will only remain on while you're in a specific application. So for example, if I switch the magnification on now, and I move to the last screen in the settings menu, I'm still in the settings application. But as soon as I leave the settings application, so if I press the home button, you can see it turns the magnification off. So if I go into another application now, such as Audible, you can see now that I don't have magnification on anymore. I can just switch it back on by triple tapping with one finger. And again, I can tap on that. When news reached him, the landing of William at Pevens. And what often you do find as well, is sometimes when you change screen, the magnification will switch off as well. It's easy enough to switch it back on, but it is a little bit of a nuisance, and it is a limitation of the Android magnifier. So, I hope you found this tutorial in using the magnifier and improving the text size on the Nexus 7 useful. If you'd like to learn more about what we've done in today's tutorial, the show notes will be available at www.quickguides.sitairdale.org.uk. If you'd like to know more about Sitairdale, then please visit our website at www.sitairdale.org.uk, or you can like us on Facebook or subscribe to our YouTube channel.